Well, last month, the 11 News I team exposed a Medicare policy change that left a local woman struggling to afford a medication that actually helps her breathe. Tonight, a cancer patient faced with a life and death situation is another Medicare policy change case, and it's left him unable to afford a drug he desperately needs. 11 News I team reporter Deborah Wiener investigates.
By all accounts, Rex Mills should not have seen this tomato season.
If we can both keep it up, at least until the harvest, we'll have something going anyway.
He has lived with stage 4 pancreatic cancer for 11 months, a wrenching prognosis that can mean just 6 months to live. Rex, his wife and doctor believe these pills may be why Rex is still here. Pills covered by Medicare until one horrible day. Rex's wife, Jean.
It's almost like someone is making your life and death decision for you. And that's just not right.
Since 72-year-old Rex was diagnosed back in September, he has been on a chemotherapy regimen that includes an IV infusion at the University of Maryland Medical Center and 42 pills a week of the drug Zoloda. It has never made him sick, in fact, only made him better.
People come, they see me, and they say, Rex, if you didn't tell me that you had this, I wouldn't even know you were sick. And to me, that's good because it gives me a good feeling.
But the good feeling changed when Rex's pharmacy announced Medicare, which was covering the drug, had suddenly declined payment because of revisions for off-label medicines issued June 1st. Zoloda's labeled use is to treat other cancers, including breast and colorectal. Wife Jean contacted the I-team for help.
Now, I am not a political person. I am not an activist. All I am is an American woman that's concerned about her husband's health.
Without Medicare, the anti-cancer drug would be completely out of reach.
180 pills is more than $6,000.
Correct.
To be exact, the amount charged, according to this Medicare document, $6,427.98 for about a month's supply. Rex is down to his last pills.
And I am just very concerned that if this medication stops, his health is going to deteriorate very quickly.
Rex Mills is not alone. It's estimated that dozens of other pancreatic cancer patients being treated at the University of Maryland Medical Center have been affected by this revision in Medicare policy, and surely more nationwide, adding a whole new level of anxiety to their lives.
This is a big deal.
Oncologist Dr. Naimish Pandya and his staff have scrambled to help patients to minimize interruptions in their care.
Mr. Mills is now 11 months on this treatment and showing no evidence of cancer progression.
It's extraordinary.
Correct.
Why stop it?
I don't want to.
Dr. Pandya says even though the drug Zoloda is being used off-label, when it is combined with an infused chemotherapy drug, it is very effective.
In the current political dynamics, there's always this microscope on healthcare costs. And whereas that may seem all black and white, there are lots of shades of gray that need to be addressed.
When the I-team contacted Medicare to alert them about Rex Mills, we were told officials were reevaluating the policy, basically turning the huge government ship around to resolve the problem. Within days of our initial conversation with Medicare, Rex's pharmacy received this policy revision for oral anti-cancer drugs like Zoloda. Medicare was paying for the drug once again.
It's going to be okay that I'll be able to live what's left of my life and don't have to worry about spending all my money.
The Mills hope Medicare officials realize wholesale policy changes can have dangerous implications. But for now, they are living each day fully. Next month marks 1 year since Rex was first diagnosed. For the 11 News I team, I'm Deborah Wiener.
Now, in its revised policy, Medicare officials indicate they may re-examine other drugs that were affected by their decision made earlier this summer.